Well, I think they have to look out for slightly slower growth in 2018 than 2017, probably about 4.5% per annum. But still growth, which is good. I think they have to look out for bigger ships and cascading of ships into secondary trade routes, which is still well underway. And I think they also have to consider more mergers, acquisitions and alliances in order to cope with the challenges the industry is going to face. I think there's vast potential for automation and new technology in the port industry. I think the challenge is finding their way through the myriad of opportunities and possibilities. There's so many different options in terms of automation, digitization, artificial intelligence and so on, that the big challenge is how do I choose and what's best for me. No, I don't think we have a two-tiered system. I think, you know, there are big ports, medium ports, small ones. It's horses for courses. There are major transshipment hubs, but they're not taking over the world. And certainly the big ships that we see deployed around the world are multi-port calling still. They're not just calling at one port in each region. They're calling at many ports. So we'll still see that layering of ports and not a separate kind of Premier League. Well, I think port operators have to keep informed, for sure, keep abreast of all the developments. So intelligence and understanding is very important. And I think they have to find the right partners in technology, in other aspects, in commercial aspects. It's about partnerships as well. Well, I think for greenfield ports, it's important to be realistic about the rate of return that you expect to get from your project. You have to do your financial model very carefully and weigh up whether that rate of return is acceptable, because it may be less than it was in the past. I think you have to think carefully about partnerships in the terminal, whether you need to involve a shipping line, for example, in the ownership of the terminal to make it a success. And then I think you have to make sure that you're driven by the market and not by politics or geopolitics, that you follow the cargo, and that's your primary concern. Well, I think brownfield ports and terminals, their main focus has to be how do I optimise my facility? How do I get the best out of that facility? Be that by addressing costs or attracting more volume. Linked to that is the question of automation, the subject of this conference, of course, and the value or otherwise of retrofitting automation to brownfield terminals. And then I think the third point would be to say, are there ways that I can merge or work more closely with my neighbouring terminals in a particular port? Because the demand is for bigger terminals in each port, so are there ways that I can work together with my neighbours and competitors? Yeah, I don't think we'll see that, because if you're a major shipper, you need to keep your options open. You need choice. Choice is valuable. It can give you better prices. And also, you can't cover the whole world on your own, even if you're on Amazon. There are big shipping lines out there that have been around for many years that have extraordinary networks covering every port pretty much in the world. And there's no sense in replicating that.